We are having a shibiram, a 3-month shibiram, and we are reaching towards the end of it. I don't know whether the participants have developed any new habit after coming here. One point I would like to tell everybody is, be thoughtful, be thoughtful, be thoughtful about the work you have done, the life you have led, the desires you fostered, the resistance you showed, the reactions and responses that the mind produced from time to time. All these call for a thorough examination. This examination will reveal to you whether, as a person of quality and character, you have improved, you are improving or not. One important word I would like all of you to understand is purity. Whenever we say purity, invariably people have a dislike or a repulsion towards it. On the other hand, what I would say one should have is, you should love to hear the word purity. Purity of substances is what we want. Purity is the right quality. Whenever you purchase any item of food or dress, what is it that you are looking for? The fabric with which the dress is made should not have any knots in between. The weaving, spinning, everything should have been all right. And when you pass your fingertips anywhere on the cloth, there should not be a resistance, it should be smooth. Today I was folding my bed sheet. I found that the bed sheet was not sufficiently rectangular. 4 right angles together to make, it's very, very impossible almost. If a factory can make a cloth which is a perfect rectangle or a square, all the 4 angles are equally right angles, I think it has reached almost perfection. Whenever that perfection or perfect right angle is not there, you will find one edge is protruding. That is not purity, it is impurity. If the mind becomes pure, you will find proportionate to the purity, it will become joyous. It will become delightful. It will become very serene. Suppose you have an impure mind, that mind will be heavy and it will be a load. So why should we not like purity? Purity in an individual, purity in a family, purity in gold, purity in copper, purity in stainless steel. Everything purity is the standard as well as need. When you make a coin, that coin should be such that it will not attract much of a dust. It will remain clean. What kind of a shape, what kind of an elevation should be given can be thought of. If an industry or a trade has to survive, they must have purity with them. Purity is a quality, and quality by its very nature is desirable and covetable. In the whole of spirituality and religion, one word is purity. The pure mind is itself God. When your mind becomes pure, you become godly and you become God. What do you say? So purity is not something that you should resent or be repelled by. It is a quality that we need. A man of purity. See, a man may be very learned and efficient. He is very efficient. Suppose he doesn't have purity, then do you think you can use him, employ him for anything? Maybe a little inefficient, but he must have purity. What is meant by purity? You can think about it. Every quality proceeds from purity and converges towards purity. when you are pure, you get a strength. I may be inefficient, but I am pure. When the purity is there, people have to honor it, recognize it. It is something like innocence, truthfulness. A pure mind will alone be able to have 100% or very near that loyalty. Why are you not able to think of God and rely upon Him? It is because of impurity. If your reliance on God has to be wholesome and consistent, then you must have a pure mind. We have been discussing the subject of experiential Vedanta for so many days now. The long and short of it is that our participants should have the strength of purity. Purity, purity. It is like pure milk, pure air, pure water, pure human, pure mind. I would like you to think about it. You tell me, which are the circumstances in which a pure mind becomes either a load or uncomfortable? Whenever we are sending a letter, I want the letter to be positioned properly on the letterhead. Depending upon the contents, the top free space and the bottom free space should be matching. They should be proportionate. Where you put the date, where you put the number, how is Harihi Om Tat Sat written, where do you position ultimately Antaratma and my name and signature? What is the space between the paragraphs? What is the space between the lines? All these things have to be gone into. Our Sridhar is very particular about making letters. Generally, when they make their letters, bank and finance and other things, I don't go through them, but sometimes I read. So when I read the letter, I found that he said, "Swamiji, I have gone through it so many times, but see, I missed it." And whenever you miss, you should not get sorry. You should not get dispirited. You polish a table. The more and more you polish it, you will find the unpolished dots will show off. Initially there will be nothing. Polish it well. Then you will find altogether 50 spots are there. Polish it further. The 50 will get reduced to 10. Polish it further. It will reduce to 5. Then finally you will find everything is polished. Two places it is not. So the two will be glaringly seen. It is not that the polish is not all right. The polish is so well done. That is why the unpolished spots show off so much. So I think I would like you to have a new insight about purity. Have a pure mind. Try to dress yourself in a pure manner. Have pure habits. I think this is what we are here for. We must be clean. We must be tidy. We must be orderly. Everything, everywhere. We were sending our letters. Our letterhead is in the parchment paper. So when the letter is a little long, we have to use an additional sheet. That additional sheet becomes the computer paper, white color. Somehow it is something like sugar and black gram joined together, put together. So we were saying that it's not right, let us have the same continuation sheet. So yesterday I called Gopalakrishnan and told him, can we not have, what is the minimum that you want to have? Let us have a packet of 500 sheets. So he has sent it yesterday. Why this feeling that it should be so? I think it is a quality. I was signing it, but I was not happy, though it is white and pure. So I think a sense of proportion is very important. I would like you to become pure. You may not become honest. Honesty will not be sufficient, pure. From purity, all other things go. That purity alone will make an industry lasting, a trade viable, any kind of an undertaking, a family, an individual, a marriage, any kind of an institution. In our ashram also, the purity is what is going to sustain us. When the number of people and inmates becomes more, we find it very difficult to maintain the purity. We are telling everybody repeatedly, repeatedly, repeatedly. Some people will pick up, some people will not pick up. What can be done? That is why verses from Bhagavad Gita, Sarvarambhahi doshena dhumena agni riva avrata. All undertakings are associated with some evil, just like fire is associated with smoke. I chant these words, console myself and keep quiet. So I thought I would tell you today about what is purity, how it becomes a demand, how it becomes a quality, and how all other qualities that you can think of are around, revolving around this one word called purity. Try to understand it. When you understand it, you will automatically become pure and want to become more and more pure. Harihi Om Tatsa Jayakuru.